It is a pleasure to be here again in the Ministry of Communication. I had this portfolio for nearly 3 years, from 14, and handled law and IT for 5 years, again back handling all these departments. What is very exciting for me to note is the sheer size of the Indian Mumbai Congress in the last 3 years. From a very modest beginning, and I was perhaps involved in the first Congress, it has grown in size, grown in stature, and also grown in repute. Today is current Reza. What is important is Indian Mobile Congress is becoming significant, not only in India, Asia, and in some way part of the globe as well, because it is growing in sync with the march of India and the country of global repute. Our government has come back again with a renewed mandate, a more heavier and substantial mandate. Today I would like to briefly share with you what has been our vision, what has been the journey, and what the role of you have played, and what you need to play in the future, for which the Indian Mobile Congress can become an important center to facilitate that growth. Our Prime Minister has always felt that India has to reform and perform in order to transform. No initiative should be there which is reform simplicity unless it leads to transforming the quality of life of ordinary Indians. That's the mandate he has given to all of us. And in this whole ecosystem, technology was to be in the center. Programs like Digital India, Make India, Startup India, Skill India, Smart Cities, Stand-up India, are all technology-based programs. But all are transformative. And why do Mobile Congress need to kindly think its role in the larger narrative of transformation? Because mobile has been an important component of that transformation process. Arun has mentioned about Digital India. What is Digital India simply means? What it means simply? A program to empower ordinary Indians with the power of technology. To lead to digital inclusion, bridging the digital divide between digital haves and digital have-nots. And this must happen through technology which is low cost, developmental, and innovative. Homegrown. With this basis, we started this program. And see where we are today. You must remember one digital provider in India. Population 1.3 billion. 30 crores. Mobile phone 1.21 billion, 121 crore. Internet close to 7 billion, 70 crores. And Raj, what is the number of smartphones? 70 crore, 121 crore? I don't know any data. Data, we have smartphones, our phone is close to 70 crores. But what impresses me most whenever I go into the internet of India? The biggest passion is for the smartphones, even the poorest people.
a smartphone, it is a moving computer. It is a store of information.
Ladies and gentlemen, how India is changing.
Yesterday I shared with the head of WhatsApp what happened to me. And I would like to share with you, Raja just mentioned about my election campaign, but you didn't come to campaign for me. That I wanted, okay? No problem. I had to campaign in a remote DR area, and people who are aware with North Indian profile, DR means villages across the big river, which becomes inaccessible during floods, for instance. In a big backward village I had gone, a huge crowd of almost 70,000 people welcomed me. While I was sitting on the dais, two young boys were jostling with each other. And I will mention their language and then translate it in English. They said, Jaldi Photoa Kichi Mobile Se, Facebook Par Load Rehao. I was taken aback. Click on mobile, I have to load on my Facebook. I was amazed. How digital India has changed in India. In the remotest part of the village in Bihar, normally inaccessible, I had to go on a pontoon bridge which is now no more there. The Ganga River has become big to come again in October. The passion for getting my photograph on mobile loaded on the Facebook is a new empowerment. Therefore, a reform performed in order to transform. That is happening all across. Programs like e-hospital, e-visa, e-scholarship. There's a big common service movement happening in India of nearly 80,000 plus, I don't know what, between IT industry also. We have scaled to 300,000 plus, 3.65 lakhs. Young boys and girls giving digital delivery of services, land records, passport, ticketing, digital literacy, healthcare, the longest time put them into access to justice for the poor. I'm amazed to see how entrepreneurship is being promoted and accelerated by one device called the smartphone or the laptop. The stand-up India, startup, what is stand-up India? The PM was very keen that those of our brothers and sisters from the marginalized and deprived community should not be left out of this transformation process. And then came Startup India for SCST boys and girls to be given fast bank relief. And how India is changing. Imagine we have so many COI to CII to FICCI. There's one body, I have a patron of that body, I'm very grateful to you. Dicky. Dalit Village Chamber of Commerce. And the head who started it was the Junior Engineering Education Department in Maharashtra, Dalit. He could have got accelerated promotion one day and decided to become an entrepreneur. His father kicked him out of his home. What the hell are you doing? You better become chief engineer. You got job at the age of 20. Today now he's got only 100 crores and he has assembled about 500 Dalit entrepreneurs. And the theme he has given is, we are job givers and not job seekers. That the India has looking forward to. Again, this transformation is happening. This is of smartphones. Why I am seeking to give this larger vision to you? Many of my patients from Bihar but now want to come to AIDS to get medical care. We have a tradition in Bihar, we have to get all sorts of checked up in AIDS. And pressure on me and others, I asked my team to find a digital solution on the appointment. You come to Delhi, get a registration, can go back, then a date is given, today you can book an appointment online, 300 hospitals. That's what we have done. I only want you to understand the enormity of challenge and the comprehensive opportunity within four offers to transform India. And I want the CUI team to keep this larger narrative of digital inclusion happening in India also as the theme of their discussion. Yes, new technology must come, why not? But what is the special focus India offers to the developing world is something which also needs to be properly conveyed. As Arnold rightly pointed out, the range of technology is involved. And there were 5 years involved. But I am very clear, I don't want 5G simplistic to be adopted. I want innovation in 5G. I want creation of patent in 5G. I want Indian TSP, I told them in the meeting today, that please involve yourself, why not, with the global success of Digital India. Because remember one thing, in India, Digital India is not IT simplicity. Digital India is beyond IT. Indians have done well with the thing of IT. Therefore, in a similar way, when our technological prowess and capabilities are being globally recognized, my vision is very simple and my ambition is very focused. Can we have some India-related patents developed for the 5G applications? Probably registered. Think about it. That's what I am thinking will be interested. Many of you who know me, I'm a little hard task master minister. I will personally monitor it. And that will be the happiest day for me. And I wish to thank my DOD team. They have already created the test beds for 5G in many of the IITs. We want to enlarge it further. So that, with the involvement of COI, private sector, TSPs, and all the IITs, we are able to develop some good, innovative 5G products. Not only for mobile, but also for healthcare, also for education, also for infrastructure development, and a whole range of other activities good for society. And this 5G, along with artificial intelligence, IoT, and new technologies, must blend with each other so that they all are working in an ecosystem where they are working together to ultimately strengthen the net product, and the net product is transformative. And I'm very clear, ladies and gentlemen, because Digital India, when I started on the 1st of July 2015, I was one of the pioneers as a minister in charge. Startup India also was involved. Can you believe we have 19,000 startups in India? Launched 4 years ago, 7,500 are technology startups. 8-9 are unicorns, that means $1 billion turnover. And the biggest day for me was when last year, a year before, I had gone to Bangalore to award the Economic Times Startup Award. I was only a young, honest boy, not even yet, by space up. He has raised $500,000 already. This is a startup, he got number one. I want this new India to grow further and further. And I want mobile sector to ensure that these startups are encouraged more and more. Therefore, I want mobile sector to work in conjunction, in cooperation with the startups. And this I have said at some place today in my first interaction as the new communication minister, I wish to share my views with all of you. I have been an activist for my school life. Many of you know me. I have a long career in public life. MP for the last nearly 20 years, minister in the Bajpai government. Why is the minister in the movie?
But the India has seen as the IT Minister of India.
It is truly remarkable. And my take is very clear. No power on earth can stop India becoming a truly global power with the model of technology. That is what I am saying. Because ordinary Indians have a battle for it. And as I have said on some occasion, first they observe technology, then they adopt, and then they start enjoying it. Therefore, if in this transformation, mobile phones play the most crucial role, you need to showcase this transformation also in mobile phones, from technology to inclusion. And giving a suggestion to you, can you have a proper platform there where you can showcase small, medium enterprises, domestic enterprises who are helping this process with their products? And let me tell you, with my exposure in various parts of the world, all of them look towards India. Then before last, I went to Bahamas in the Commonwealth Law Minister Conference. It is a four-day conference. And every time I normally try to also push my digital India platform. And every African minister started saying, Mr. Minister, we want to know more about digital India, about Aadhaar, about India's mobile transformation. Therefore, any Indian initiative is going to find its way. This 5 trillion economy is not at all a target, not capable of being achieved. And I have been giving you empirical evidence of that. In 2014, when we came, what was the ranking of India's economy? 11th in the world. And after 4 years, 4.5 years, we became 6th. And God willing, very soon we will become 5th. In Bali, Kashmir, only 5 months. हमारे प्रधानमंत्री सिर्फ बड़ी तस्वीर दिखाते हैं और करके दिखाओ वो करना है। फिर तो नॉर्मली इन कैबिनेट से वाह यार 18,000 विलेज स्टिल द विलेज कौन कर रही है क्या कर रहे हो तू लोग 6 months करो मतलब इन 4 months तो ये विलेज और नाचर और मारवाले और इन इंटरनेट और इंडिया इलेक्ट्रिसिटी रीच I told the same thing today to my friend from the all the mobile brands. Today 43,000 villages are unconnected, but the mobile hasn't reached. I have given them 1 year. Mr. Matthew, karna hai, okay? You know what I told them? That's what I have told them. And I'm sure they will deliver. That's how we have to work. Skilling, to e-commerce, all the technology is they are rising in India, they have a population, and all of this are going to be mobile based. And we are pushing the case of 1 million people. But now, does it mean IT, broadband electronic controls? Now, government has come to power, there are only 2 mobile factories, only 2. Now India has 268 mobile factories in the world. Even 6 lakh jobs. And since 6 crore to nearly 29 crore. From nearly almost 6,000 crore to 22,000 crore. Other electronic manufacturing is also rising. Now I have set a mission, and where I would like Shivai to join with me. India must become the center of telecom equipment manufacturing. I want this to happen in India.
And surely COI will also become a partner in that process.
Low-cost telecom products, why not? There is enough scope for this.
The only last issue I would like to flag, I'm very keen that India must become the big center of data. Data analysis, data refinery, data innovation, data safety and security. Our data protection law is complete, a little work in progress, we are soon going to come. We'll make a robust data protection law in India. I need to share my view about data which I have shared on the other platform. Our view of data is very straight and simple. We in India generate billions and billions of data. The size of India. And our premise is there must be a proper blend between data availability, data utility, data innovation, data anonymization, and data privacy. All have to work together. And India has got enough potential to develop as a big center of data analysis and also data refinery, cleaning the data, anonymizing the data, with regard to privacy, security concerns, critical data. And India will never compromise its data sovereignty. This should be very clearly noted. We have come with all the policies, the digital communication policy is there, the new electronic manufacturing policy is there, the open software product policy is there, the new software product policy is there. So we have nearly done all the policy, and also the digital communication, from spectrum sharing, harmonization. Whatever you have asked, I have left nothing. And as Balaji rightly said, after becoming a minister, I took a review, and even without losing, I have taken the initiative for all. I will do my best, but we will do well together. The common team to make India a real digital superpower. Thank you a lot, Namaskar.